Hello, I'm the Wanting Newbie, and it's time for more Record Keeper. Been a bit since we had videos slash streams, and also been a bit since we had an FF3 event. Last time was Onion Knight, and that was way back in 2016, actually. This one, themed around the Cloud of Darkness, and the levels here, themed around each of the Crystal Guardians, excluding the odd man out in Bahamut. But the big thing is to get started with the boss rush, which is kind of a weird boss rush because it's the Zonde clone from Crystal Tower, and then Zonde. Both bosses actually fight incredibly similarly. I just think Zonde has access to more spells. He has Meteor instead of Quake. Ridiculously similar, focused more on magic mitigation and a dispel to take care of their Protect, Shelga, and Haste. Oh, Zonde clone is in the Dark World. He gives you the ribbons. Alright. That makes FF14 make a lot more sense, actually. Where you open up a random treasure chest and Zonde clone comes out as a trash mob. Good times. That's a good dungeon. Sadly, he does not give you the ribbon in that. Anywho. Ignis will be taunting and then dispelling. Lunith will be doing his jumps. Raphia doing her monk stuff. Onion Knight debuffing the magic, and Arc protecting the party. I believe these bosses don't have anything AoE, so the Gaia Slash is enough to deal with their stuff. See if we find a cool rando. I should have muted my phone. Mildly want to see if we can find something FF3 related. Can't be looking for roaming warriors forever. Also, I'm about to roll over my stamina cap. Real talk, Crystal Tower is an extremely good song. The FF3 soundtrack overall is kind of fantastic. It was like they were really sort of mastering the NES soundtrack. Alright, I couldn't remember where I left off from last stream. Man. I want some good boy gear. Yet the good boy eludes me, always. The animation's alright. Oh, that's the one that gives you the status break, or status shield, doesn't it? Now, we do have to remove his haste as a condition. Thank you. Oh. He gives shell too? Huh. There you go. Say goodbye to all of your buffs. Alright, time to finish this clone off and then go deal with the real thing. I have to say, the Zonde clone is holding up way better than the World of Final Fantasy summons were holding up. See, that's an interesting point, because for me, on my alt, they actually casted Haste on turn 1, so I assumed it was a force action. And then, when I did one of the later bosses, the triple plus, I actually beat the fight without ever removing the buff that you're supposed to remove, and then I went, oh. I see. Here's the big man himself. Excuse me. Yeah, so Zonde's biggest, most dangerous thing is that he can, in fact, use Meteor. Which can really mess you up. Though a Magic Blink is very good at preventing that mess up. The, again, side problem with that is his Magic Blink, or your Magic Blink, very likely it would get popped. Blue Sacks, that was kind of the visual fuck-up I really did not need. Your Magic Blink is very likely to be popped by his, any of his spells, before you actually use it on Meteor. In Ever 3, Zonde generally only has two actions, Scan and Meteor. Sounds like a fun boss fight. Now, interesting. Oh, right. The caster of the roaming warrior actually gets instant cast for a couple of turns. That's it. Like I stated, the Zondes really aren't that rough if you bring heavy magic mitigation, since they are actually mostly magic. Also, we made a joke about this during the Ario Sorrow stream, but I'm a really big fan of the fact that the story of FF3 is literally, there's no difference between light and dark, you idiot. I forgot to put up the fucking... Now it's there, so I can make the edit later. Alright, so Cerberus is the double plus. The biggest thing with Cerberus is that it actually acts three times every time it goes. Though it is not even mostly physical. It actually has a lot of potent spells, so I actually, once again, recommend magic mitigation over physical. And we are very much so going to attempt to mitigate magic. Right here, magic lore should do most of the work for us. We do have a Shelga, and he will also be taunting. Ignis is pretty much just going to try and shut this guy down. The four Dark Fiends are what? Five-Headed Dragon, Ahriman, Cerberus, and... Oh, Two-Headed Dragon is the fiend? What's a Five-Headed Dragon? Was that just a thing made for 14? Echidna? Interesting. 14 Echidna shows up in an entirely different dungeon. Dogs can't talk. Alright, so you may notice that we actually don't have any physical mitigation up at all. So this first turn's gonna suck. Or Cerberus can just not take any turns. We're fine. Some people got poisoned, that's pretty much the worst of it. Alright, there. Other than his AoEs, he cannot deal damage to us, and I think he only AoEs about a third of the time. Not a lot of good that's going to do him being halfway dead already. It's not even like the AoE did much damage anyway. I feel like I need to stop taking buffs to the double pluses to give them a fighting chance. I'm just being so mean. Hey, that's the good shit right there. a new memory crystal to throw on the pile. I say throw on the pile, but actually, let's just go check that out real fast.
Yes!
Yes! Fancy man arrives. Anyway, yeah, I say throw on the pile, but actually, all by herself. Boop. What does Omnicast Dark mean? I actually don't know. So, Leviathan being our triple plus. Like most encounters with Leviathan in FF3, the scariest thing about him is that his attack can petrify. He also acts twice and can protect and haste. Cripplingly weak to lightning, resists ice, water, and earth. A fairly simple fight. Dark magic AoE is not bad. We're finally subbing somebody out for this one. And bringing in Desh. Now the real question is, who does the roaming warrior? I think it's Lunith. Desh obviously doing protect because he can. Paired up with Ark to keep Ignis safe. Ignis will be taunting and is also coming equipped with Petrify Resist. If he does get petrified, well, that's the thing that will occur, won't it? I hate the song. On the entire soundtrack, and they use it for the daily dungeon. Alright, good. Ignis goes first. You get that taunt off. Get our defenses up. And now we really don't actually have to worry about his damage. For the most part, the magic might still do a lot of damage. That is yet to be seen. At the very least, unless I roll a natural 1 and Ignis gets petrified, we should be good. Now, the all-important question of, will he cast haste? Because you see, if the serpent does not cast haste, then I will, for all intents and purposes, lose that condition. Probably still master fight, because I won't take that much damage, nor will it take me that many turns. Due to my proper mitigation here. That said, nah, we'll be alright. Yeah. How'd that work out for you? Yeah, we missed the condition. But honestly, with proper preparation, you don't really have to worry about that condition at all. As stated, you do run a risk, so if you are taking a lot of damage, I would recommend trying to wait for that haste and remove that haste. But yeah. Now I can do the good EXP farming. Hell yeah. That's right, baby. The Sunday daily, still. It's better EXP. Dire Heal is a very nice move. It is Dark Zone, maybe a little weaker than Dark Zone, but will heal the caster. So it gives Dark Casters, which are generally pretty squishy, a way to heal themselves. Sundaily does not have onion modes. So first up, Hecaton Cheer and the Gaps. This is a gauntlet boss. You have to fight three waves of Gaps, and then Hecaton Cheer. I believe, yes, Golbez is Darkness 5. Big thing here is they are all weak to dark. In fact, if you hit a gap with an ability that isn't dark, let's see if we find it. Actually state it. Once you defeat the first gap, another two will appear. Defeat the gaps three times. Yeah, gap single target. Blah, 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 blah. I hear you. You start by facing a pair of gaps. If you attack with elements other than dark, they'll keep increasing in number. So use those dark abilities to battle them. Yes, we are utilizing Reigns. Since we have to get through these first three phases only using dark abilities. Dark or dark-like products. So this is Alphanod. Alphanod has equipped my health staff. That's my strategy. Pretty much, it's going to be Cid Reigns on Kuja and Alphanod. Of course, utilizing Memento Mori on Kuja to give him equal magic to Alphanod. Wave 1 will be casting the Roaming Warrior to kill the guys there. Hopefully. We have fail safes here, but, you know, hopefully we kill. Maybe we'll slow it down and I'll use a Darkrai or a Draenga at first, just to make sure that gets off. Round 2 will be the AoE. In fact, I might do that. I might utilize Draenga. Yeah. Second turn is Memento Mori. Second turn is Command 2 on both of them, which should kill Wave 2. Wave 3 is Command 1 with each of them, which should kill Wave 3. And then we spam Command 1 on Hecaton. Remember that Dark Zone has an increased multiplier when under Doom. I believe it is bigger than Dire Heal when under Doom. Yes, there you go. 1303. 1305. Anywho. Enough stalling. Let's have at it. Did I get my picture? I took my picture. Good. As a matter of fact, I'm foolish. I almost went in here with the wrong setup. Dire Heal is actually probably going to become a more stable addition to my setup. Whenever I normally would have brought Dark Zone, I'll probably bring Dire Heal now. Alright, let's fish for that rains. Ah, there we go. Perfect. Even has synergy going. Kuja's a good dark boy. Cloud of Darkness 4. Whoops. Not rename properties. Those two options are right next to each other. Perfect. Biggest sort of rough thing in this whole fight is the fact that Onion Knight actually can't do anything until we get to Hecaton Cheer. If he were to smack either of these boys here, we would immediately fuck up. I believe they multiply from non-elemental. I'm gonna shrug and not take the risk. Okay, we did not have to do that one hit. Noted. If we don't make it, we'll write that one on the note sheet and say, don't actually have to wait. That's alright. These guys are dead before they act. And then slam that button. And we'll hit Hecaton with the good attack down before he can even act. Yeah, this seems like an alright strategy. I mean, any strategy that incorporates Sid Rain's is usually pretty alright. That's the one danger move, is his Quake. Does hit really hard. Earth Resistance, obviously very good for that. Committing Record Keeper crimes today. Yeah, so that was a fight. That happened. Strategy worked perfectly. I can't actually add any more to that. I'm gonna check a thing real quick. I've been paranoid about this recently. Nope. Okay, good. It's off. Check my audio settings real fast. Yeah. As stated in the chat, Sid reigns supreme. Shrugging at the theoretical camera right now. Alright, that was the easy round. Ultimate Plus. Zonde's back. So the biggest, roughest thing here is this one right here, Ultimate Meteor, which is a group magical, non-elemental attack that ignores resistance. He also has Fireaga, Thundaga, Blizzaga, but you know, you'll want to stack magic breakdowns and what have you. He can attack twice and can give himself Protect Shell and Haste to bring a Dispel. Also, only resist all elements except for Dark. Fuck. You could Sid Rain's this, and Sid Rain's may be the backup strategy. I want to try something else first and see if that works. The party I'm about to put forward works either or with Sid Rain's or with not Sid Rain's. So here's Kuja. That's Kuja's magic. So the big thing here is Fang will be up top, jumping, doing damage that way, draining if she needs to. Kuja. Is remove haste a condition? Oof. Well, we'll see how that goes. We got double healer on this, and Onionite doing debuffs. This works in theory. If this does not work, however, I am just going to Roaming Warriors at Reigns and see if that works. Whoops. This should be support damage. Never change that over from the last fight. Yo, Desh is really good. He has a surprisingly robust skill set for a mage. I definitely recommend using him if you pull this shit. Yeah, so I'm gonna be honest, we might be here for a tiny bit. My understanding from reading Japanese reports and everything, Zonde is a bit of an RNG fight. Because he can just decide to throw meteors at you, or he can decide not to. Either way. There's our dark condition. Okay. Ark's gonna be on standby a lot of this fight. Pretty much just hitting, debuffs and what have you. If they pop up. In fact, we should have him defend on the next turn if Zonde doesn't buff himself. Thank you for making my job easier. So far so good, but we haven't hit the kill condition yet. And honestly, Zonde's been being pretty nice, all things considered. Oofa, I went for the heal, and there she blows. He can counter shell? Oofa. Yeah, he's not fucking around anymore. Goodbye, selfie! We're fine. We're not fine. Something... Or he got way buffer. I need to see if he gets way buffer. As it's that or something fell off. Ah, he gets way buffer. This is really having a time right here. Why does this do this sometimes? It was fine. We just got RNG'd into the second... There was a couple RNG things that occurred right there. First of all, he used it. Blue sacks, please. I'll say real quick. Yeah, he gets counters in that last phase, which I was not aware that he had. Blue sacks, fucking please. I have to kill blue sacks. Yeah, we were fine until he double cast Meteor, and really, the solution there is, well, A, I should have started casting Curata earlier, and B, he caught me when I did a Dragoon jump with Fang instead of a Drain jump. Otherwise, I had it kind of under control. He just starts hitting way harder in that last phase. Thank you. Oh, you can even see how much his meteor actually jumped up in damage, too, on top of everything else. Alright, back at it again. If we start using Curatas a little earlier, that might help us out. I have two healers, I should utilize it a bit better. By the way, while checking the AI routine, no, there is no RNG aspect to this fight in dealing with him hopefully casting haste. He is scripted to cast haste during certain times. Speaking of which, we'll probably get another one of those in a second. I'm gonna be preemptive. Oh no! I wanted that to be a jump. So far so good in that we are being successful by the complex strategy of fuck it, he's just not casting haste, or casting the death move. There it is! I spoke too soon! Holy shit! This is fine. Good boy, finish him off. Good boy, I want to believe. Good boy, good boy. It's your boy. Kuja. Good boy and bad boy are cops. They fight demons. Yeah, that works alright. You just gotta be lucky and not get hit by two meteors and have your health restore skills on the standby. Kinda works. A salute to Selfie, as always. Yeah, casting the Curatas earlier also really helped. Okay. It's Garuda, motherfucker. Garuda takes two turns every time. Uses Thundara, Thundaga, Lightning, which is a percentile attack, and Ultimate Lightning, which ignores resistance. Vulnerable to Wind, so utilize that, and only resistant to Earth. Fuck. Jump Steal extra damage. Huh. Vulnerable Wind and jumps deal a lot of damage. Huh. Well, I planned jumps anyway. He is weak to the jump element. That's fantastic. So, Onion Knight and Ferris will be debuffing. Fang up top will be jumping. I'm actually bringing Tyro because I figured jumps and drain jumping in order to keep himself up, and only Dragoon that can cast 4-star magic. And Selfie, of course, healing down bottom. And because I always allow myself two things and a very limited synergy in this realm, Selfie is a super healer in this fight. I wonder if, like, because they're not typed jump. Dragoon BSBs aren't typed jump. Only the intro is typed jump, the entrance. The commands aren't. I'd be extremely interested if there is one where they are typed jump and can be utilized in this. Here we fucking go. Uh-oh. Is that going to stabilize? Alright, we've stabilized. Actually, give me a hot second. I just need to hit up something real fast. Sorry, side business. Okay. Yeah, that seems about right. This boss and stupid bullshit tactics. Well, I've selfie healed the Onion Knight. Targeted. That's doing good damage, though, at the very least. That's less so. It might actually be worth it to craft another instance of, what's it called? Drain jump. And hone that up. At least you know lightning dive works. Damage actually seems to be pretty alright, as long as we can hold out the whole fight. I say as I proceed to get my ass kicked. That's more than normal damage. Alright, we have the damage, that's for sure. Let's see if we can no-healer this? I don't think I can no-healer this, but... Yeah, so, that's a rude as shit move. We have the damage. We just need to survive. Oh, that's max HP. Oh, no, wait, Ultimate Lightning is just the really strong one. That's right. Alright. I just need to Medica when the opportunity arises. Thank you. fucking turn one lightning just, like, actually fucking kills me. Both in that it does a lot of damage, and it's like, you actually can't have anything up for that. Mayhaps a honing of lightning that... Oh no, because we actually need Sky... Dragoon. The Wind Dive. Yeah, its AoEs are just super rough. And I would care not for them, maybe a bit more. Like, come on! Fang will be kind of fine because she'll hopefully be in the air. Oh right, he's taunting. Hopefully this Kiraja will tag Fang on her way down. Or that's just gonna go to the Onion Knight again. Hopefully this works. For like, Fang will come down because of this long animation, and then the AoE goes off. Perfect. I just need the boss not to go. Whew! And Fang continues to be stupidly low on health because of jumps. Jumps have their downside, people. Yeah, but the problem is when she's on the ground, a meteor will just kill her. Or ultimate lightning. And there goes my damage. Let's actually see if we can still pull this off, though. We got one less hypothetical mouth to feed. We never hit the wind condition. Fuck! Thank you. God, he just moves so fast. The leech life was definitely a very good plan. That's for sure. I think if I had to change something, I would maybe switch Ferris over to Steel Power. Wait a minute, I'm all physical. Why am I not using Shout? Huh. Alright, White Magic is fast compared to other ability classes, so this Kiraja should go off first. Hell yeah! The stealth heal. Snuck it in there. Well, yes, but I'm fairly certain I'm going to make the damage on this. I'm just going to be safe here. This won't hit Tyro, but he has a self heal anyway. Oh, geez. This boss sucks. Fuck it. Go for it. No, Ferris is about to get. Not Ferris. The double hit. Maybe Tyro can finish it off himself. This isn't gonna happen. Yeah, I think we regroup and grab a shout. Tyro was definitely gonna run out of ability uses, I could tell. Also, if Tyro didn't run out of ability uses, what was going to happen was he was going to run out of the Onion Burst buff, and in turn start doing way less damage. At least Garuda always seems to start off with the same two moves, which is like small blessings. That said, you always start at a deficit on this boss. I love that there were two other characters that could have hit. Yeah, that's better damage. Of course, Fang was already hitting the stat cap, so her damage isn't going to go up very much. Oh, I really need Good Boy to not die. Oh boy, okay. That's really rude. Alright. Fang should land after this, and we'll make a small recovery. Fang's gonna die. I haven't been timing my heals right. Unless he attacks now. Nope, he waited just long enough for Fang to come back down. I didn't get wind off. I need to use that earlier. As like a failsafe. Because I might be able to keep fighting and finish it. Yeah, I might be able to keep fighting and finish it, but I need to hit that win condition. So, on this first turn, I think we use Sky High instead, since both moves just do 40k. There's no reason to really use one over the other. We're in danger of losing either Selfie or Onion. Again. This boss is mad rough. Alright, good, good, good. I'll take it. Oh god. Good. It's gonna go exactly to the person it needs to go to. Perfect. Less so. Tyro is pretty self-sufficient. He is just constantly doing max damage and healing himself. We do not need to worry about Tyro at all. Except for when he gets double tapped. Then maybe a little bit we need to worry about Tyro. There's that ultimate lightning. Yeah. Fuck you too. God, ghosted. When you gamble on auto-targeting. And you get the double. Oh baby, it's a double. Dragoons. Away. Launch my Sky Knights. Oh god, my Sky Knights, please survive. Rain down the pain! Hell yeah. Yeah, so just a proper balance of drain moves and timing your healing right for your Dragoons wins that fight for you. Like, there is an argument for maybe replacing Drain Jump with Wind Jump, but no. Drain Jump made Tyro pretty self-sufficient. I never had to worry about him. It was really Fang I had to worry about, but Fang was doing most of the damage, so I couldn't remove any of those moves. Yeah, no, this strategy works. Really, really, really well. I like it. Like, part of me is thinking, what if I replaced Drain Jump on Tyro with, like, Dragoon Jump? Or something like that. It's like, ah, you're dealing damage faster. But it's like, no, then he's not self-sufficient. Like, that was the big thing about that, was Tyro was 100% self-sufficient. I'm gonna give an attempt at this. Just mainly, I am a little tired. But I do have a party set up for said mission. Shenanigans. The only thing I would have to do real quick is I need to egg the cloud. To the requisite submission, but I just got this character level. I have many eggs. Eat your damn omelet. This is going to be the same strategy. Just replacing, of course, her with Dire Heal. Dark Zone with Dire Heal. The big thing of note here is Ignis is going to be our off healer. We'll see how this works. I have him equipped with a mind thing, so he has a okay mind stat. Really not sure how this is gonna work, but I'm hopeful. Now, I am slightly cheating. It's a Sid mission, baby. I'm gonna treat it like one. Which means I can't go full ham. Because I also don't want to be here all night. But I'm only bringing, like, one break. That's Ark. Yeah. Doesn't have to be pretty. Just gotta win. Thank you. Nice. That good fucking dispel double cast. Oh. Stay with me, blue stacks. So the heavy regen is going to help a lot in this scenario. But, with the Curata on somebody else, we can actually focus a bit more on getting those HP buffers up. Ah, and now we see that the fight has gotten real. What? Everything is working out, kind of? Oh, piss. You can't counter shell. That's so rude. That's not magic. It's not real magic. I'm just gonna keep this healing going. She's doing enough damage through shell that it doesn't matter. Also, that's coming. Hell yeah. Arc down. Cloud down. Yo, Lunith isn't gonna get this, but whatever. Or maybe he will. Remember, doesn't have to be pretty, you just have to win. it's way easier to keep three characters alive. Uh-oh. God. Zonde, chill out. All right. I think things have worn off. Yeah, this is a done deal. We're dead. Try it again. Only I didn't lose, like, the cloud, pretty much. Losing cloud is what did me in. Oh, wait, he has to cast Protect, yeah. Oops. Should maybe have, Lunith recast the Roaming Warrior as soon as he runs out of Dragoon Jumps. That doesn't actually sound like a bad idea. Probably get the haste right here. Called it. Now, I think we actually want to keep Ignis on standby. Some people still had fucking... Hell yeah! some people still had Magic Blink. You dick. Hoofa. That's super rude. Cloud is extremely capable of keeping herself alive right now, and that's gonna pretty much get us the win. He would stop casting Counter Haste. It was right there.
Wrong call.
That's pretty rough. Definitely RNG based, but this party works. The only thing I used was a Magic Blink shell. Alright, the heavy regen I'll give you. But you can get the shell with his default, so there's that. You won't have the blink, but generally that blink should be gone by the time the first ultimate meteor comes down. So you're just saving a bit of damage there. No, that works. Oops, hit the wrong button. Let's go peep some banners. Okay, so banner 1 has the Dragoon Lance, Heavenly Gust, it's Lunate's OSB, wind non-elemental damage, more damage for more wind moves used. It's alright, it synergizes well with his BSB, unfortunately outside of that it's a bit harder to use, because it's about like 2 or 3 wind abilities that he can use aside from that. Staff of the Magi is Arc's BSB. 5 holy hits, non-elemental, restore HP. Temporarily raise the user's mind. And grant haste and burst mode. Asuna and a large heal and Medica commands. It's a good healer burst. Cloud Darkness burst. Eight holy dark, because she is of course Flood of Light or Cloud of Darkness. Grant all allies reflect barriers. 4, Holy has chance to silence blind. 4 that have a chance to paralyze and stop. So good status effect synergy right there, just in general. It's alright. It doesn't infuse her with darkness, I think. Barrier. Though the reflect damage is pretty alright. That's an okay mage darkness break. Gungnir is, of course, Lunith's Windbreak. It's one of the best Windbreaks out there. The entrance has a 100% chance to stun and also inwinds you. Command 2 is an attack boost with resistance down. Command 1 is 4 hits with a chance to stun. This is fantastic. It easily bumps Lunith up to like the upper echelons of good character. Cloud of Darkness, Super Soul Break. Yeah, it sucks. Yeah, that no bosses are really vulnerable to status effects. That's where that sort of bumps down. Anyway, Anti-Air Particle Beam, 5, Dark Holy, and Infused with Dark. That works really well with a lot of the moves that we've gotten lately, such as Dire Heal and what have you. Memento Mori, take your pick. This synergizes pretty well. With Cloud of Darkness, I actually like that. Gaia Blade. 8 hits, non-elemental, 1 target, lower attack magic. Sure, it's also breakdown level, so hell yeah. Small earth boost for what it's worth. What it's worth. Rising Sun. 8 hits, grant haste to the user, raise attack and defense. I'm never really big on the self buffs, but I've had situations where they help, and the fact that it is a stacking buff is really good. So, that's alright. That works. Elder Staff is Renewing Reigns. We saw that in the video. This is a good workhorse of a move. Gives you Shell. Gives you Magic Blink. Gives you a heavy regen. Just fantastic all around. Good at the beginning, good at the end. Heroic Shield is Protect and Haste. It's an alright thing to start a fight off with. And it's Haste Daga on somebody who isn't your healer. So, pretty alright. Onion Armor is the OSB coming back from the Fest Banners. It's a physical or magic, non-elemental, mattering on what is the higher stat. That's pretty good because you can build the Onion Knight any way you want and still be able to use this. Avenger. Ancient Lightning. It's just 5 lightning hits, and infuses the caster with lightning. 2 is a magic up, defense down. 1 is 4 magic, and reduce the user's cast time. So this is Rain's Burst without the stat buff, and instead lightning infusion. That'll get some work done. Ignis's is pretty fantastic because it raises the user's attack and defense. It's an AoE, and then with Secret of Sasune and Tour de Force, it allows him to retaliate and taunt. So it's taunt retaliation on a not samurai knight. That doesn't happen too often, and it's pretty good when you can do that. Onion Gauntlet is Vessel of Fate. What more do I have to say? This is fantastic. Onion Sword is Onion Slice, which is a defense, resistance, large down, and the number of attacks is dependent on the speed of the Onion Knight, and I think the only way to actually get max is for him to be under a burst buff. I believe a level 99 Onion Knight will get 10. And, oh, Ignis can actually dive to Samurai 3 if you don't get his buff, so there is that. Anyway, back to this. Defense resistance down, stackable, is really good, and if you can get him under burst buff when you use it, it deals a lot of damage, like huge amounts of damage. The Eternal Staff is the healer side of the Onion Knight. It is 5 9 Well, it's more the sage side. Let's put it that way. It's 5-9 non-elemental hits and moderate HP restoration to all allies based on their HP. So it's percentile heal. I like that. If you're building them as a mage, that'll do work. White Mage Robe is Word of Kindness and is a Medica with Physical Blink. Very good. Also, the Holy Boost on it. Very useful. Ancient Sword is Lightning Hits, raises the user's magic, and also lowers their Imperil Lightnings. Also very good. And Gauntlets is Selfless Spirit. It is a attack defense raise on the party, but hurts Desh quite a bit, so you have to plan around that. However, a stackable attack buff is never bad. Let's see what happens. Nah, alright. I never noticed that there's actually a dragon on that hat. God, that looks such a stupid looking hat. Now, my 3 synergy is actually pretty bad. It's not fantastic. And in a void, let's put it that way, in a void, I would highly recommend pulling on Banner 2. The Onion Knight stuff is on here. Desh's Burst is on here. Ignis's Burst is on here. Those are fantastic. Eternal Staff is pretty good, as is the Onion Sword. Word of Kindness will do a lot of work. Ancient Sword is alright. Selfless Spirit is alright. So in a void, I would say pull on this banner. However, the synergy that I'm actually lacking is physical synergy. And there's only actually one offensive weapon on this entire banner, and it's a burst. No, no, it's a Super Soul Break. I'm sorry. That also said, I have this, and I have this. So this isn't actually a good banner for me to pull on. On the flip side, this has 1, 2, 3, 4 physical weapons on it. And I only have one item. Mind you, a dupe of this would be really bad for me since I already have an 8-star of it. However, sometimes you gotta roll them dice. So, let's make bad decisions. Alright, 2. Okay.
Here comes 2 stacks.
Alright. Oh well. What are you gonna do? Sometimes the draw isn't kind to you. However, I will easily take 2 new bursts, especially a Haste Aga. A Haste Aga not on a support. And, my 5th Undark. Yeah, no dupes. There you go. That's the best way of looking at it. Also, I kind of like the Cloud of Darkness, so there you go. Also, yes, my fucking 5th Undark. Cloak comes with plus dark on it? Fuck yeah, it does. Hell yeah. That's rad. Yeah, also, synergy armor. You always gotta look at the bright side of stuff. I'll get a weapon eventually. I had bad realms, like 5 was really bad for me for a really long time, and I eventually got something for that. I'll get a weapon. Or I just pull in the next banner. Either way, I need to do an outro. Anywho, that's it for the FF3 event. I did that thing that I do sometimes where I forgot to check the next event. It's 11, actually. Holy crap. Alright. So next time, our first FF11 event. I'll see you next time.